Now, this is how World Cup visitors experience Germany. All these ratings close to or above 90%. Fantastic mood, great experience, nice people, felt welcome, hospitable, Germans are fun. And this is how many people would recommend Germany as a tourism destination. 88%, with only 3% saying rather not. Now this is a key benchmark for 2010, to convert visitors to brand advocates that going home will recommend the destination to their friends and colleagues. And it's a very measurable benchmark that was recently termed by Harvard Business School the Net Promoter Score, and very simply requires you to subtract the detractors, that people that would not recommend your destination, from the promoters, the people that would definitely recommend your destination, and then arriving at the Net Promoter Score, which in Germany was 85%. And that means hosting the best World Cup ever, simply to convert 9 out of 10 visitors to brand advocates for country and continents. Now, the image transformation in the media, also quite dramatic, because the media after the World Cup, when they spoke about Germany, did not use words like effective and efficient. They used words like party, proud, successful, positive, and friendly. And last but not least, a very sustainable effect on the economy with 1.1 million jobs created within a year after the World Cup. Now at the end of the German World Cup, Kofi Annan, the former UN Secretary General, stated that what impressed him the most is that how the World Cup turned into a platform to unite the entire nation. So the question is, when the final whistle is blown on the 11th July 2010, will Madiba hand the World Cup in nation building to South Africa? And will the media title their story something like this?